Good day. God bless you. My name is Pastor Adeboye Ajayi, by the grace of God, the parish pastor of RCCCG Thanksgiving House, based in Chelmsford, Essex, United Kingdom. And we're reflecting from the Open Heavens Daily Devotional Guide, written by Pastor E.A. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God Worldwide. And our topic today is Godly Sorrow. The main Bible passage is taken from the book of Luke, chapter 22, verse 60 to 62. But Peter said, "Man, I do not know what you are saying." Immediately, while he was still speaking, the rooster crowed. And the Lord turned and looked at Peter. Then Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times." So Peter went out and wept bitterly. A memory verse is taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 10. For godly sorrow produces repentance, leading to salvation, not to be regretted, but the sorrow of the world produces death. Our reflections. Godly sorrow is a condition of feeling very sorry for a sin or a wrong committed against God or an individual. This can be accompanied with weeping and remorsefulness as seen in the life of Peter in the passage that we have just read. When Peter realized that he did not fulfill his promise to Jesus that he would not deny him come what may, he went out of the place of denial and wept bitterly. When an individual is confronted with the reality of his sinful life and the certainty of hell, if he's not hardened up in his heart, he would mourn for his sins. The best way to mourn or show godly sorrow is to confess and repent from those sins. According to Proverbs chapter 28, verse 13 to 14, which says, "He who covers his sins will not prosper, but whoever confesses and forsakes them will have mercy. Happy is the man who is always reverent, but he who hardens his heart will fall into calamity." There are many believers today that are not looking inwards, but at other people's sin and as such are not quite aware of their own sins. Jesus told us about the Pharisees and publicans in Luke chapter 18, verse 10 to 14. Two men went up to the temple to pray. One a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, "God, I thank you that I am not like other men, extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even as this tax collector. I fast twice a week, I give tithes of all that I possess, and the tax collector, standing afar off, would not so much as raise his eyes to heaven, but beat his breast, saying, 'God, be merciful to me, a sinner.' I tell you, this man went down to his house justified rather than the other. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted." It is time to look inwards, truly examine ourselves, and see where we are falling short of God's grace for living holy. Let us repent genuinely and come back to our first love as you go and seek the face of God. May God revive you today in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I need a reviver of holiness. Please revive me again. Amen. Have a good day and God bless you.